Okay, students, I would discuss today, I would discuss the definition of coset and then applications, that means some theorems proved. So first, definition of a coset, definition of a coset. Already, suppose let W be a subset. Let W be a subspace of a vector space V of F. Let W be a subspace of a vector space V of F. Then for any element alpha belongs to V, the set W plus alpha equal to set of X plus W such that X belongs to W. First, suppose let W be a subspace of a vector space V of F. Let W be a subspace of a vector space V of F. Let W be a subspace of a vector space V of F. Then for any element alpha belongs to V, then any element alpha belongs to V, then any element alpha belongs to V, the set W plus alpha equal to X plus alpha such that here X belongs to W. W plus alpha equal to Z of X plus alpha such that X belongs to W is called the right coset. Is called the right coset of W in V. So it is generated by alpha. So once again, let W be a subspace of a vector space V of F. Then for any element alpha belongs to V, the set W plus alpha equal to set of X plus alpha such that X belongs to W such is called the right coset of W in V generated by alpha. So similarly, the left coset, suppose the set alpha plus W equal to alpha plus X such that X belongs to W. Here alpha plus W equal to alpha plus X such that X belongs to W is called the left coset. It's called the left coset of W in V generated by alpha. So here W be a subspace of a vector space V of F, then any element alpha belongs to V, the set W plus alpha equal to set of X plus alpha such that X belongs to W is called the left right coset of W in V generated by alpha. Similarly, the set alpha plus W, here W plus alpha, here alpha plus W equal to alpha plus X such that X belongs to W is called the left coset of W in V generated by alpha. Next, now since W plus is a subgroup of the abelian group V comma plus, since W plus is a subgroup of the abelian group V comma plus, by commutative property x plus alpha equal to alpha plus x. Suppose by commutative law a plus b equal to b plus a. A plus b equal to b plus a, then x plus alpha equal to alpha plus x for all. Here for all x belongs to b and alpha belongs to b and x belongs to w. Alpha belongs to v and x belongs to w. Hence w plus alpha. Hence w plus alpha is called simply the coset. Simply the coset of w in v. Coset of w in v generated by alpha. Generated by alpha. So finally, let w be the subspace of a vector space V of F, then for any element alpha belongs to V, the set W plus alpha equal to set of X plus alpha such that X belongs to W is called the right coset of W in V generated by alpha. So similarly, the set here W plus alpha, here alpha plus W, here X plus alpha, here alpha plus X. So alpha plus X belongs to, such that X belongs to W, it is called the left coset of W in V generated by alpha. So since W plus is a subgroup of the abelian group V comma plus. So by commutative property, X plus alpha is equal to alpha plus X. Here A plus B equal to B plus A. So for all, alpha belongs to V and X belongs to W. Hence, W plus alpha is called simply the coset of W in V generated by alpha. Now, some applications of cosets. Now discuss some applications of cosets. Suppose here for 0 bar belongs to V, that means 0 vector. 0 bar belongs to V, 0 bar plus W. Here 0 bar plus W equal to W. 0 vector, that means 0 bar plus W equal to W. Here therefore W is itself a coset in V. W is itself a coset in V generated by 0 bar. Generated by 0 bar. Next, second one. Here for X belongs to W and X plus W equal to W. X belongs to W, X plus W equal to W. The coset X plus W equal to coset W. Coset X plus W equal to coset W. Next one. Suppose another application. Suppose any two cosets of W in V. Any two cosets of W in V are either identical or disjoint. Here either suppose alpha plus W equal to beta plus W. Alpha plus W equal to beta plus W are either identical or disjoint. Here alpha plus W is equal to beta plus W, or alpha plus W intersection beta plus W. Alpha plus W intersection beta plus W equal to non-empty, that means pi. Here alpha plus W intersection beta plus W equal to pi. Next one. Suppose some alpha plus w and beta plus w are two cosets of w in V, then alpha plus w equal to beta plus w. Alpha plus w equal to beta plus w implies alpha minus beta implies alpha minus beta belongs to w. Here alpha plus beta equal to beta plus w, then alpha minus beta belongs to w. This is the important result. So listen carefully. Alpha plus w equal to beta plus w implies alpha minus beta belongs to w. This is the some few applications of cosets. Next, another definition, quotient, q u o t I e n t, quotient set. Here quotient set means, suppose let W be a subspace of V of F, W be a subspace of V of F, then the set of all cosets W in V, then the set of all cosets of W in V denoted by V by W, let W be a, let W be a subspace of V of F, subspace of V of F, then the set of all, then the set of all, then the set of all cosets of W in V, of W in V denoted by V by W, denoted by V by W. So V by W equal to set of W plus alpha, set of W plus alpha for all alpha belongs to W. W plus V by W equal to W plus alpha for all alpha belongs to, for all alpha belongs to V. So it is called, is called the quotient set. Once again, let W be a subspace of a V of F, then the set of all cosets of W in V, it is denoted by V by W, then V by W equal to set of W plus alpha for all alpha belongs to V is called the quotient set. This is the definition of. Okay students, now theorem using cosets and quotient set. Suppose let W be a subspace of a vector space V of F. Let W be a subspace of a vector space V of F, then the set V by W is a vector space over F. Then the set V by W is a vector space over F for the vector addition and scalar multiplication. Vector addition and scalar multiplication defined by W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to W plus of alpha plus beta for all alpha comma beta belongs to V. And second one is A into alpha plus W plus alpha equal to W plus A alpha. A into W plus alpha equal to W plus A alpha for all A belongs to F and alpha belongs to V. Now coming to the proof, here W is a subspace of a vector space V of F. Next, then the vector addition and scalar multiplication defined by the two conditions are given. First of all, it is well defined. First of all, well defined. That means addition of cosets is well defined, and scalar multiplication is also well defined. First of all, well defined, that means addition. Suppose let W plus alpha, W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha dash. W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha dash. Then alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. Alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. Next, second one, W plus beta equal to W plus beta dash. W plus beta dash, then beta minus beta dash belongs to W. Beta minus beta dash belongs to W. Hence, then alpha minus alpha dash here. Alpha minus alpha dash plus beta minus beta dash belongs to beta minus beta dash belongs to W. Implies alpha plus beta, that called positive elements, minus of here alpha dash minus common plus beta dash belongs to W. Alpha plus beta minus alpha dash plus beta dash belongs to W by known condition. Here W plus alpha plus beta equal to W plus alpha dash plus beta dash. W plus alpha plus beta equal to W plus alpha dash plus beta dash. Hence, therefore, addition, that means addition of cosets, cosets is well defined. Is well defined. Once again, alpha W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha dash, then alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. Similarly, suppose beta plus W plus beta equal to W plus beta dash, then beta minus beta dash belongs to W. So alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. Here beta minus beta dash belongs to W. Then using these conditions, alpha minus alpha dash plus beta minus beta dash belongs to W. So positive conditions, some alpha plus beta minus of alpha dash plus beta dash belongs to W. Next, here by known condition, this is alpha plus W plus alpha and this is alpha plus W dash. Then alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. Using this property, this is alpha minus, suppose this is alpha dash belongs to W. That means W plus alpha, alpha means alpha plus beta equal to W plus alpha dash plus beta dash. So addition of cosets is well defined. So second point, now coming to the second point, here W plus alpha, second one, W plus alpha equal to W plus W dash. W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha dash implies alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. Already we know that W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha dash implies alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. Here alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W and the scalar A belongs to F. Suppose A belongs to F, then implies A into alpha minus alpha dash belongs to A into alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. By scalar multiplication, suppose alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W, A belongs to F, implies A into alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. So then by scalar multiplication implies A alpha minus A alpha dash belongs to W. Already we know that A alpha minus A alpha dash belongs to W implies W plus A alpha equal to W plus A alpha dash. W plus A alpha equal to W plus A alpha dash. Then scalar multiplication, then scalar multiplication of a coset is well defined. So second one, W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha dash implies alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. Alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W, comma A belongs to F. By scalar multiplication of a vector, A into alpha minus alpha dash belongs to W. So A alpha minus A alpha belongs to W. W plus A alpha equal to W plus A alpha dash. So scalar multiplication is well defined. So by above two conditions are well defined conditions, then now coming to the axioms. Vector space axioms. First one, now we shall show that the quotient set, that means V by W is a vector space. Now V by W is a vector space. Now we shall show that V by W is a vector space. Here first one is closure. First one is closure axioms. Already we know that closure axiom means closure property. Suppose alpha comma beta belongs to V, then alpha plus beta belongs to V. Alpha comma beta belongs to V, then alpha plus beta belongs to V. It is called the closure. Suppose let alpha comma beta belongs to V implies alpha plus beta belongs to V. Alpha beta belongs to V implies alpha plus beta belongs to V, and W plus alpha, and second one is W plus beta belongs to quotient space set, that means V by W, that means W plus alpha comma W plus beta belongs to V by W. Now W plus alpha plus, and second one, W plus beta, W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to, by using the above condition, W plus alpha plus beta, W plus alpha plus beta. So W plus alpha plus beta belongs to V by W. So W plus alpha plus beta belongs to, it is a belongs to V by W, that means quotient set. W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to W plus alpha plus beta. So W plus alpha plus beta belongs to the quotient set V by W. Since W plus alpha belongs to W, V by W. Second one, W plus beta belongs to V by W. Then W plus alpha plus beta belongs to V by W. So it is a closure under addition. This is a closure property, is satisfied. Next, second point, associative. Associative means A into B plus C equal to A plus B into C. This is the associative law. A into B plus C equal to A plus of B plus C equal to addition. In addition, A plus of B plus C equal to A plus B plus C. Suppose in multiplication, A into B C equal to AB into C. So that is multiplication, this is addition. So A plus B plus C equal to A plus of B plus C. So now coming to the associative property, here three vectors, W plus alpha, second one W plus beta, third one W plus gamma belongs to V by W. Suppose let W plus alpha, W plus beta and W plus gamma belongs to the quotient set V by W. The quotient set V by W. Here suppose W plus alpha, W plus beta and W plus gamma, suppose the constants A comma B comma C. Suppose A, B, C. So associative in addition, A plus of B plus C, A plus of B plus C equal to A plus B plus C. So here this W plus alpha plus of W plus beta plus W plus gamma equal to W plus alpha plus W plus beta whole plus W plus gamma. So students, here W plus alpha, W plus beta and W plus gamma belongs to V by W. For alpha, beta, gamma belongs to V. Alpha, beta, gamma belongs to V. Here now W plus alpha plus W plus beta. Here W plus alpha plus W plus beta, this is A plus B plus W plus alpha, this is the value of C. A plus B plus C. Here W plus alpha plus W plus beta whole plus W plus gamma. A plus B plus C, which is equal to here W plus by known condition W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to W plus of alpha plus beta. So this is W plus alpha plus beta and again plus W plus gamma. Now this is again in the form of W plus alpha plus W plus beta, again W plus alpha plus beta, which is called W plus of alpha plus beta plus gamma. So W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to W plus of alpha plus beta. Here alpha plus beta is suppose A and this is B, suppose W plus A plus B. Now separating the vectors, here alpha plus beta plus gamma, alpha plus beta plus gamma, which means alpha plus of beta plus gamma, alpha plus of beta plus gamma. So now W plus alpha plus W of beta plus gamma. So now W plus alpha plus W of, here by condition W plus beta plus alpha, here W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to W plus alpha plus beta, here beta plus gamma, then W plus beta plus W plus gamma. So finally W plus alpha plus W plus beta whole plus W plus gamma equal to, suppose this is A plus B plus C, which means A plus of B plus C, that means W plus alpha plus of W plus beta plus W plus gamma. So associative is satisfied, then therefore V by W is associative. V by W is associative. So roughly just W plus alpha plus W plus beta plus W plus gamma belongs to V by W. Here alpha, beta, gamma belongs to V. Next, now W plus alpha plus W plus beta plus W plus gamma, which means W plus alpha plus beta, this is some property, the above property. W plus alpha plus beta plus W plus gamma. Now W plus A, suppose W plus B, W plus of A plus B. So alpha plus gamma. So by using the property of associative, alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to alpha plus of beta plus gamma. So W plus alpha plus W plus beta plus gamma. Now again W plus beta plus W plus gamma. So A plus B plus C equal to A plus of B plus C. Therefore, V by W is associative. Now, point number 3, that is called, first one is closure, second one is associative, third one is identity. Suppose W plus some 0 vector bar, that means W plus 0 bar comma identity, W plus 0 bar, W plus 0 bar comma W plus alpha, W plus 0 bar and W plus alpha belongs to V by W, belongs to V by W. For alpha belongs to V. For alpha belongs to V. Here 0 bar is called 0 vector. Now W plus 0 bar plus W plus alpha, by above this condition, this means W plus 0 bar plus alpha, that means W plus alpha. W plus 0 bar plus W plus alpha equal to W plus 0 bar plus alpha, that means W plus alpha. Here 0 bar being the identity of V, identity of V. Similarly, W plus alpha plus W plus 0 bar, W plus 0 bar equal to W plus alpha plus 0 bar, that means W plus alpha, W plus alpha. So W plus 0 bar plus W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha. Again W plus alpha plus W plus 0 bar equal to W plus alpha. It is the same result. Hence the identity is satisfied. Therefore W plus 0 bar, W plus 0 bar is additive identity. In V by W. So W plus 0 bar is the additive identity in V by W. So W plus 0 bar and W plus alpha belongs to V by W. So W plus 0 bar plus W plus 0, W plus alpha equal to W plus 0 bar plus alpha, simply W plus alpha. So similarly W plus alpha plus W plus 0 bar equal to W plus alpha. So W plus 0 bar is the additive identity in V. So next, identity is completed. Next, inverse property. Already suppose some alpha belongs to V implies minus alpha belongs to V. Alpha belongs to V, minus alpha belongs to V. Now W plus alpha plus W plus of minus alpha, W plus alpha plus W plus of minus alpha equal to W plus of alpha plus minus alpha, which means W plus alpha minus alpha, W plus 0 bar. That means simply it is additive identity, additive identity. So additive inverse is existence in V by W. So additive inverse is exists in V by W, then inverse is satisfied. Suppose let alpha belongs to V implies minus alpha belongs to V. Here already we know that alpha belongs to V, minus alpha belongs to V. Now W plus alpha, W plus alpha plus of W minus alpha, W plus alpha minus plus W plus of minus alpha equal to W plus alpha plus minus alpha. That means W plus alpha minus alpha, that means W plus 0. So AD2 inverse is exist in V by W. Next condition. Next condition is commutative. So already we know that commutative means A plus B equal to B plus A. So commutative property here, W plus alpha plus W plus beta, W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to W plus of alpha plus beta, W plus of alpha plus beta, which means by commutative law alpha W plus beta plus alpha, here A plus B equal to B plus A. So W plus beta plus W plus alpha using this property. So W plus beta plus alpha equal to W plus beta plus W plus alpha. So W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to W plus beta plus W plus alpha. So commutative is satisfied. So addition is commutative. So therefore V by W, so it is a commutative by above condition. First one is closer, second associative, third identity, fourth inverse, and last one commutative. So these five conditions are satisfied, then V by W, then V by W is abelian. Is a abelian group for addition. So V by W satisfied the following five conditions, that means closer, associative, identity, inverse, and commutative. Then V by W is a abelian group. Next, coming to sixth point. Now coming to the sixth point, here already A belongs to F, A belongs to F comma W plus alpha and W plus beta belongs to V by W. W plus alpha plus W plus beta belongs to V by W. Now A into W plus alpha plus W plus beta, A into W plus alpha plus W plus beta equal to A into W plus alpha plus beta by non given condition. A into W plus alpha plus beta, that means W plus A into alpha plus beta. W plus, suppose the condition to given condition to A into W plus alpha equal to W plus scalar multiplication A W plus A alpha. So A into W plus alpha plus beta equal to W plus A into alpha plus beta. Now W plus scalar multiplication A alpha plus A beta, A alpha plus A beta, which means W plus A alpha plus W plus A beta, W plus A alpha plus W plus A beta, that means A into W plus alpha plus A into W plus beta. So A into W plus alpha plus A into W plus beta. So sixth condition is satisfied. Next, coming to seventh condition. Here, case number 7. A comma B belongs to F and W plus alpha belongs to V by W. Suppose A comma B belongs to F, W plus alpha belongs to V by W. Now, A into, suppose consider addition A plus B. Suppose A comma B belongs to F and alpha W plus alpha belongs to W, then A plus B into W plus alpha. A plus B into W plus alpha equal to W plus of A plus B into alpha. This is condition. A into W plus alpha equal to W plus A alpha. So A plus B, W plus A plus B into alpha, that means W plus A alpha plus B alpha. So again, the first condition, W plus A alpha plus W plus B alpha. W plus A alpha plus W plus B alpha, that means A into W plus alpha plus B into W plus alpha. A into W plus alpha plus B into W plus alpha. So seventh condition is satisfied. So A comma B belongs to F, W plus alpha belongs to V by W. So A plus B into alpha, W plus alpha equal to W plus A plus B into alpha. This is condition number 2. So W plus A alpha plus B alpha, W plus A alpha plus W plus B alpha. So A into W plus alpha plus B into W plus alpha. So seventh condition is satisfied. Now coming to the eighth one. A comma B belongs to F, W plus alpha belongs to V by W. W plus alpha belongs to V by W. Now A into W plus alpha, A into W plus alpha equal to W plus AB into alpha. W plus AB into alpha. This condition is used. A into W plus alpha equal to W plus A alpha. That means W plus, already we know that AB whole alpha equal to A into B alpha. A into B alpha. So A into B alpha. That means here A into W plus B alpha. A into W plus B alpha, that means A into B into W plus alpha. A into B into W plus alpha. So therefore, AB into W plus alpha equal to A into B into W plus alpha. So eighth one is satisfied. So next property number 9. Suppose alpha, W plus alpha belongs to V by W. W plus alpha belongs to V by W and identity and unity, that means 1, belongs to F. W plus alpha belongs to V by W and W, suppose unity, that means 1, belongs to F. Now 1 into W plus alpha, 1 into W plus alpha equal to W plus 1 into alpha. This, using this property, A into W plus alpha equal to W plus A alpha. So W plus 1 into alpha, that means W plus alpha. So finally 1 into W plus alpha equal to W plus alpha. So all the conditions of a vector space, all the conditions of a vector space are satisfied. So hence V by W. So V by W is a vector space. So hence V by W is a vector space. Here all the conditions means, first one, closure, associative, identity, inverse and commutative. So 5 conditions are satisfied, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 conditions are satisfied, then it is an abelian group. It is an abelian group. 6th one, 7th, 8th, 7th, 6th, 7 and 8, 9 conditions are there, then totally 9 conditions. That means all the conditions of a vector space, all the conditions of a vector space is satisfied, then V by W is a vector space. So the theorem, hence the theorem is proved. Okay, students, thank you.